once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Where the planets, moons, and stars all shimmer, shine. Having a great time, exploring space racers.
Hey, wait for me!
Happy Valentine's Day, Hawk.
Happy Valentine's Day. Robin, Eagle. Aw, that's so sweet. Huh? What's this? But who sent it? Headmaster Crane always talks about observing stuff to learn about it. So, here goes. Meet me to find out who I am, far side of the moon, at 10 a.m. These coordinates follow true, and I'll be there awaiting you from your secret Valentine. Hey, but there's no signature. I guess that means I have a secret Valentine. But who is it? Hey, Kiwi.
G'day, Hawk.
So you didn't send me anything, did you?
Like what?
Oh, I don't know. Like through the mail or something?
It wasn't me. Sorry, mate.
Oh, well, thanks.
Hey,
Raven? Did you, send me anything through the mail?
Oh, me? Nah, I never use regular mail. Too old-fashioned.
Oh, yeah, right.
Well, I gotta get out of here.
Oh, me too. Later, guys!
So, somebody sent you something?
Nah.
Come on, Hawk, I know you. What is it?
This Valentine's Day card.
You mean mine? I got yours too, thanks.
No, not yours. This one. It wasn't signed or anything.
You mean you don't know who sent it? Mysterioso! Can I see? Smells kind of familiar.
You're right!
Maybe the smell is a clue to who sent it.
I don't know.
Aren't you curious?
Yeah, of course.
So you're gonna go?
Go where?
To the far side of the moon.
Why would I want to go to the far side of the moon?
To meet your secret Valentine.
My secret what?
I'll go with you.
You will?
Sure. This is a mystery. And you know how I love to solve mysteries.
Launch sequence initiated in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Booster rockets.
Engaged.
Wings.
Back.
Space visors!
Down!
Blast off! Woo-hoo!
Here we are, the far side of the moon. Even though it doesn't feel that much farther.
Well, it is a little farther. This is the side that's permanently turned away and not visible from the surface of the Earth.
Look! Somebody's coming!
That must be the rocket that sent you the Valentine! Wait a second! There are two of them!
What are you guys doing here?
Did one of you guys send Hawk's Valentine?
Valentine? What Valentine?
Hawk got a Valentine? Oh, let me see!
Ah!
Ooh, Hawk has a secret admirer.
An why not? He's a terrific rocket.
Wait, so then why are you here?
We saw you take off. Raven was curious, so I tagged along to keep him out of trouble.
Like I need you to keep me out of trouble. So, where's your secret admirer?
Didn't show up.
Eagle, what are you doing?
Observing.
Didn't we already do that?
Yeah, but I'm observing more closely. Tools like this microscope can help.
Hey!
Let me see.
Can I see that?
See this stain? It looks like fuel, but not any fuel I've ever had at the Academy.
You're right. That stain looks like the same color purple as the elderberry fuel my Grandma Owl used to make.
Yuck.
It was actually pretty good.
Then how come they don't serve it in the cafeteria?
Raven's got a point. They don't serve it in the cafeteria. At least not now. And Hawk, your name isn't anywhere on this card.
What's your point?
Maybe it wasn't meant for Hawk. Maybe it wasn't even sent this Valentine's Day.
I get you. Maybe it was sent a long time ago and got lost or something.
So how do we find out when?
Well, the first thing we do is find out if they ever served elderberry fuel in the cafeteria.
Elderberry fuel. I haven't had any since I was a student.
And that was here?
Yes. Elderberry fuel. That really takes me back.
Did you like it?
No, I didn't. But as a wise rocket once said, we must embrace pain and use it as fuel for our journey.
Huh?
At least we're getting somewhere. Your secret admirer sent this card when Headmaster Crane was still a student.
So it wasn't for me after all.
Sorry, Hawkey, but you can be my Valentine.
Oh, thanks.
So, what next?
We check the school records to find out who used to live in Hawk's room.
Wow, that's incredible.
Hawk, you're living in Headmaster Crane's old dorm room.
Gee, there ought to be a plaque or something.
That means that the Valentine was meant for Headmaster Crane.
Ew, it's weird sending the headmaster a Valentine's Day card.
Don't forget, he was your age then.
That's even weirder.
So who sent the card? We're running out of clues.
No, there's one more major clue. The way the card smelled.
So it smells. So what?
I've smelled that smell before.
Me too. But where? Wow! Headmaster Crane looks so young!
This old yearbook isn't telling us anything. Maybe whoever sent the Valentine didn't even go to Stardust Space Academy.
Hey, what are you kids doing? Oh, my old yearbook. Oh, I remember that day. We were all so proud. We ran the fastest race ever recorded in Space Academy history.
Gee, Sandpiper, you smell nice.
Thanks. Must be my metal polish. I make it myself.
Sandpiper? Is this yours? It kind of smells like you.
I can't believe it. There's the spot of elderberry fuel I spilled. I was so excited. Where did you get this?
It was in my mailbox.
How strange.
It must have been lost all these years, since you sent it to Headmaster Crane.
How do you kids know that?
We observed that there was a fuel stain on it, but that fuel was only served when you were both students here.
And we observed the address, and then found out that Headmaster Crane used to live in the same room as Hawk.
And we observed that the card smelled familiar, too.
Good observations. I had a bit of a crush on Craney back then.
A crush? Yuck.
Raven!
You know, I waited on the moon for hours, but he never showed up.
Because he never got your card.
There's only one thing to do.
What do you mean, Robyn?
We have to deliver this card to its rightful owner.
Oh, no. You couldn't. You mustn't. That was a long time ago.
Hey, you gotta. This is Headmaster Crane's card, and it has to get to him.
Come on, he'll be flattered. I mean, he probably never gets any Valentine's Day cards. What? What did I say?
Uh, Headmaster Crane?
Yes, Hawk?
This is for you.
For me? Meet me to find out who I am. Far side of the moon at 10 p.m. Someone crossed out a.m. and put p.m. I wonder why. These coordinates follow true, and I'll be there awaiting you. From your secret Valentine. A secret Valentine. Ava, what time is it?
Just in time to make it to the moon.
Were you listening?
Sorry, I monitor all communications at Stardust Space Academy, even the embarrassing private ones.
That's okay.
I observe that you are feeling a little sentimental, so I assume you are going.
I guess I am.